We hear about everything else, but talk about me. about your problem. Let's talk about the great I am. Yeah. Because he already know your little troubles. Did y'all hear that? Yeah. See, with him, them little troubles. Might be big to us, but to him it's small. The higher you get in God, the smaller the problem becomes. It said when an eagle soars from the ground, the higher he get, the smaller the problem looks. Because you're getting higher and higher in the things of God. What used to be big started looking small. I said, what used to look big. Some of you are still big, but when you're in Christ, when you're soul in Him, it becomes small. Because God got your back now. You know what the word says. I can do all things through Christ. That's giving me the strength. I ain't got all I'm going to get, but I'm getting it all the time. Every time I get before God, getting in word, praying, talking to God, praying to God. Scriptures here, but my biggest one, we're going to John. This one, we're going to be throwing our lesson from, but a message from. Amen. Praise God. The book of John, but we're going to start in Exodus 3 and 13. Hallelujah. Don't you, we're going to be talking about God this morning. Hallelujah. Oh, God. And Moses said unto God, behold, when I come unto the children of Israel, and shall say unto them, hallelujah. Help me, Holy Ghost. I got excited about to lose my voice while I get started. So I need some more. I need some more throat, God, to get through this. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Now, I ain't complaining about it, no. Because if that's all God's going to talk, we're going to say, hey, God's a priest already. The preach out here. I say, God's been preached out already. Hallelujah. And if he don't say nothing else in this house, but I'm just saying in this house, because he's going to be talking all day. But just have your ears on and hear what God has to say. Hallelujah. And I come to, let me start over. Moses said unto God, behold, when I come to the children of Israel and said and shall say unto them, the God of your fathers have sent me unto you. And they shall say to me, now what am I gonna tell them? And they gonna tell me, amen. What is his name? That's a good question. You telling me to go free your people from Pharaoh, from the Egyptian, and I've had the experience with you at the burning bush. So I know about your power and your authority just watching the bush burn. Now you're sending me on a mission. They've been praying to you, but they don't know you. Am I right? I've seen some of your work, but they haven't seen it at all. The only thing they know about you is what they heard about you. See, there were people that they only heard about God, but never experienced his presence. Hallelujah. And when I tell them God sent me as a spokesman for you all to tell Pharaoh to let my people go, and they don't want to know who in the world you're talking about. Hallelujah. I hear about him. People hear about him all the time. But they don't know him. That's God. We see his creation. Hallelujah. Breathing in his air. Even enjoying the sunshine and the rain. But still don't know who he is. I hear the preacher talking about him, and I hear others even mentioning him, but my question is, do I really want to know who this God really is? But we want to know, what is his name? He got to have a name. Hallelujah. Praise God. He got to have a name. What is his name? What shall I say unto them? God, I don't want to look like a fool. I need to ask. Hallelujah. Think about this though. Think about this. Now they've been praying to him, but now they won't know his name. They've been praying to him, but now, what is your name? Who is your name? Who have you been talking to all that time? Your prayer not being made because you don't even know who you've been. Oh, God, it'd be a shame for me to call on God and I don't see him. And now I want to know his name. Hallelujah. Verse 14. Hallelujah. And God said unto Moses, I am that I am. I'm Jehovah God. And that's what the word Jehovah means, I am. I am whatever you want me to be today. Today we're going to talk about God today. Yeah. You important too, but we're going to talk about God. Is that all right? That we exalt God in this house. I told you God don't need your best singer, because it ain't them no way. It's God working through, because it's all who? God. It's all God. You can't take the place of God. And thus said I said to the children, I am has sent me unto you. Hallelujah. I'm God. And I'm all y'all need to know about right now. Because I am the one that is about to deliver you. Forget about the name. Hallelujah. What's important, you've been crying out to me.
Yes, yes.
Hallelujah. And you want me what? Deliver. Hallelujah. So don't worry about my name, long as you get out of Egypt. That's what's important right now. Am I right? Praise God. Oh God. Turn with me right quick to Matthew 16 and 16 now. I'm headed to John. But we're talking about God. Oh God. Yeah. 16. Hallelujah. Oh God, 16 and 1. I said 16 and 1. We're going to start right at the 40th verse. We say, man. Oh God. Oh God, let me see. Let me turn it. We're going to get it. Amen. Oh God. 16:32. Yeah. Thank you, Lord. And when Jesus came to the coast of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, saying, whom do men say that I, the Son of Man, am? You can't get away from that A-M, am. Who do they say I am? Israel want to know what is his name. Jesus asking him a question now. Who do people say, or men say, I am? Hallelujah. Praise God. In other words, what is to you? Hallelujah. That's the question, what it is to you. Hallelujah. We know he's the big God. Hallelujah. Praise God. We know all through the wilderness how God healed his people. Hallelujah. I don't know how you may see him today. Amen. But whatever you're going through, I am. Yeah, y'all should have shouted on that one. Whatever you're going through, I am. I want to know what the world, how they viewed me and how they saw me. Hallelujah. Jesus knowing already who he is. Knowing he's the Messiah that was sent from God. Hallelujah. among y'all, and y'all seen miracles take place. Y'all seen me preach and teach. So I want to know what are the people saying about me. Hallelujah. I'm gonna pick y'all mind right now, he says. Yeah, I'm gonna pick y'all mind and see how do y'all see me. How do the world see me? Matter of fact, when the world see you, you ought to see God. Oh, I threw that over your head, didn't I? I said, when you're amongst the people on your job, do they see God operating inside of you? Who do they see? What are they saying about us? Hallelujah. Praise God. Well, boys, who did it say? Some said Elijah. Some said Jeremiah. Some says a prophet, one of the prophets. Hallelujah. I'm picking your mind right now, he said. I'm gonna let y'all think about it, but what are they saying? But I'm not worried about it. But what are they really saying? Who am I? Hallelujah. Then he poses another question. They come on to every answer, but what they should have came up with. But I'll tell you what, since y'all been with me, you've been in my presence, you saw the miracles, you saw me. The lame walk, the dumb talk, the blind made to see. Hallelujah. But, so I'm gonna ask you all the question now. Because you ought to know me by now. Oh God, saints, this ought to encourage your heart today. If there's any doubt been created in your life about God, and your trust level is so low that it ain't been where it ought to be, you ought to see these scriptures right here. When you tasted the goodness of God, why the scripture said, oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. In other words, when you've tried God and you've been tested by God and you've seen what he's done in your life and what he's doing even now, it shouldn't be a problem when it comes down who God is. And every time you run across somebody with the trust levels down, God is going to use you to tell him he's able to do it. He's able to do it. I've tasted the Lord and I saw how he works. When I was at my lowest point, God picked me up. He sent Maddie along the way and she began to encourage my heart. Yeah, yeah. Sent Darnell my way and he encouraged my heart. God used him and used her to encourage the pig. When I was down, but he picked me up with a word. Tell you, all I want to take is a word. And how many of you know the devil knows who's carrying that word? I said the enemy knows who's carrying the word for you already. And his job is to keep you from getting to that poison that needs the word. Let me prove what I just said. But Jesus said we always let us go over to the other side. Am I right? And when they get on the ship, hallelujah, no they got a man in the graveyard. Gonna get delivered. Jesus already now, already know why he's going on the other side. Because there's a man over there got a legion of demons in him. I needed to be set free. Hallelujah. And on the way, when they get right in the middle of the water of the lake, a storm rises up. Hallelujah. Praise God. And it posed that Satan was behind that storm. Because he's trying to stop him from getting to their destination. What God got for you, the enemy can't stop. He can drown, he can sit all the storms in your life if you want to, but it ain't gonna stop you. Because we're going through some storms, but we're gonna get to the other side. Did y'all hear what God? Because we got I am with us. Hallelujah. Praise God. All we need is some God chasers. I got into God chasers in the house. I said, do I have any God chasers in the house? I'm chasing after him. I'm going after God. Chasing God. Song up. God chasers. Yeah. Every chance I get, I'm chasing after him. Trying to get a word from him. God, what you got from him? I'd rather have a day, God, what you saying? I want to hear from you, God. I ain't going to let you out of my sight because I want to hear what you got. I'm a God chaser. Chasing after him. I don't want to leave your presence, so I'm going to chase after you. The Lord will around you. Hey, God. A God chaser. Yeah, yeah, yeah. But knowing he had to get to the other side, storm rises up. Posing as that sends a storm. And knowing that reason, we know it was Satan because he rises up in the back part of the ship. Steps out on board. And he says, peace! Be still. He was there and said, hush! Satan, I know that's you behind it. Shut your mouth, boy, because we get to the other side. Because if you ever doubt it, God, oh God, God say, get rid of the doubt because we're going to get there. Sweet home, we're going to get there. We're going to get there. Did y'all hear what Holy Spirit? We're going to get there. Oh God. Hey. So the enemy's job is to stop us from getting to where God want to bring us to. That's why we got to stay as one. Unified. I don't need you fighting me. And I don't need you fighting one another. Because ain't nobody in here with your enemy but Satan. And we need unison to get to the other side, am I right? And when we get on that boat, we rowing together, all right? Now somebody rowing against me, we gonna be going around in a circle. But when we rowing together, we gonna get what God's trying to bring us. I don't need no opposition to make it harder to get to what God was bringing us to. Jones. We're gonna be pulling lots and throwing you overboard. Yeah, Jonah said, I'm causing the problem. Throw me overboard, get rid of me, because I'm the one that caused the problem. And they was trying to hold on to their own problem. The man telling them the truth, am I right? Yeah, I'm running from God. Get rid of me and you get rid of the problem. Yeah, I'm going to leave that one, where is that? Hallelujah. And so, you want to know who to, boy, what y'all think about me? What do y'all think about me? I can understand the world don't know me, but y'all been with me. When I called you, I trained you. I even sent you out to minister. Matter of fact, I sent y'all out and y'all came back praising me, praising God, because he was telling me, even the demons are subject to your name. Oh man, when we went to house, folks were getting healed, they were getting saved, and we saw all that in action. But whom do you say I am? It was disappointing to Jesus because in their own finite minds, they still didn't know. Isn't that amazing? Looked like out of 12 men, they all should have just picked that up. He's got to be the Son of God. At his name, demons are running.
Bartimaeus was blind and he was made to see.
What about the woman with the issue of blood? It dried up. And he's asking me the question, us the question now. We thought we got off the hook there by answering for somebody else. Now he made it personal. And the man didn't want the thing to get personal, ain't he? We got to fight for everybody else until it happened to us. Now it's personal now. And we ain't going to view it the same way now because it's happening to me now. Well, I had plenty of advice for that other person, but now it's my turn. And they could not answer the question in their own finite mind. So what happens? God has to give the answer to Peter. Peter blurts out and said, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. But didn't God notice it? Notice Jesus already knowing all things. He reminds Peter right quick. That didn't come from your mind. That didn't come from you. God himself had to tell you who I was. You should have known it. But God from heaven had to reveal to you who I was. Very disappointing. When that happened, Jesus' whole message changed. He began to talk about the Son of Man must suffer much. He right then and there began to reveal, I'm going to die. Praise God. Oh God. Oh, man. I'm not going to finish this message. No, I'm telling it already. Go to John right quick. John. Sixth chapter. We're going to start at sixth chapter. Hallelujah. Around the 35th verse. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the book of John, it's seven statements Jesus talks about. He gives. That I am. Hallelujah. 35th verse. 6:35. Hallelujah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Hallelujah. The people were following Jesus because he had fed them. But they were following him for the wrong reason. Hallelujah. Instead of following him for who he was, they was following for free food. In other words, they was looking for a welfare, Jesus. Somebody to give them stuff. But how many of you know Jesus ain't no welfare man? God. He's a God that provides for us. Hallelujah. The only time, basically, when you see when he fed them when they were in the desert. They couldn't grow no food, so the only way they were going to eat because he made provision. And how did that happen? He rained down manna. Hallelujah. Because he said, I'm that bread that came from heaven. Hallelujah. And he began to tell them about the only reason y'all followed me because you're getting free bread. But I want y'all to know one thing, that man can't live on bread alone. You can go out there and work, get billions of dollars, but it's going to take more than money for you to live. And the life I'm talking about is greater than what you, oh God, than bread, because when the bread runs out, that's still eternal life. That must go on in your life. So I'm trying to give you something that's more than this earthly bread, but I'm talking about your life, not eternally. Something man never really looks at, that when I die, do I have eternal life? Got somebody they say today, I go to church. That didn't get you no spot in heaven because you go to church. Hallelujah. Praise God. Scripture said, if you continue in my word, then are you my disciples. Continue means nonstop. I can't come for one or two Sundays and think this gonna hit it. No, no, you're missing it. You gotta understand when you die. If you don't eat, you're gonna die. Am I right? If you starve in yourself, you start withering away. That's on the physical side. On the spiritual side. And you died out. Did y'all hear what God just said? Spiritually, if you're not getting God's word, your spirit man is dying. It's getting weaker. And Satan knows that. Hallelujah. To be dying and even don't know it. Hallelujah. Are you separated from God even now? Sin separates us from God. You're spiritually dead. Walking around, but you're spiritually dead. You die while you're spiritually dead. In hell, you're going to lift up your eyes. You're separated from God. Hallelujah. And so he says unto them that I am the bread of life. That's one I am right there. He that cometh to me shall never what? Hunger. And he that believeth on me shall what? He's saying that even though we look at the physical bread which you buy at the store, but he said, I'm offering you something even greater. It's a hunger in you that only I can fulfill. I'm that bread. While the world tried to get in drugs and alcohol, money, success, finding out they're still not happy. They still don't have no joy. Because if you don't have Christ, there is no joy. Everything else is temporary. All that stuff will pass away one day. Make all the money you want to. If you don't get the bread tonight, the man is feeding you spiritually. And that's what they are longing for, a spiritual need that only he can give. I'm that bread they're talking about. Hallelujah. I had to tell Satan that. He thought this physical body was going to fall to him or bow down to him. I had to let the enemy know that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out God's mouth. This is how we're going to live, by the Bibles that's sitting in your lap. They're going to feed me, going to keep me going. That's going to sustain me. Because after all, this is the only thing that can sustain me right now is God's word. The world's running to and fro, trying to find happiness and this and that. Worried about the economy. But I'm not worried about it because God, the bread of life. Hallelujah. I don't even have to get a shelter and store it up. Because if I'm doing what the word said do, God is already making provision for us. Can y'all hear what God's saying in this house? Working two, three jobs trying to make ends meet, but I'm the bread of life. Yeah. We'll neglect God's word trying to make a living. And he's trying to tell you, I'm the sustainer. I'm the bread of life. I am what he is to you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I always go back to Exodus when he, Pharaoh want to know who it is I am. You talking about? You mean to tell me you stand in front of the Pharaoh?
I hold the highest office in Egypt. You trying to tell me there's somebody greater than me? Had he known his creator, he
wouldn't talk like that. But he was so caught up in himself that he think he got all the authority and the power, but didn't know the big God. So when he said, I am, have sent me to tell you to let my people go, Moses, you must be out of your mind. Hallelujah. Next verse, John 8 and 12. The next I am. Hallelujah. We still talking about God. Oh God. Oh God. Ain't nothing wrong with talking about God. That's the assurance. That is the insurance. But the assurance. Did y'all get that? The assurance. Insurance there just in case you need it. We always need God. Whether you insured or not. Yeah. Praise God. Every time you bat your eye, you need God. Then spake Jesus again unto them, saying, I am what? I'm the light of the world. He that followeth me shall not walk or live in darkness, but shall have the light of life. I'm the light of the world. Because now I live in you, you become a light.
You ain't got to tell me when you're saved or not. Because if the light of Christ ain't shining in you,
you're living in darkness. Did y'all get that? And if you're living in darkness, you're living in sin. Because how do the world see you?
What are the world calling you? Are they calling you an alcoholic? Drug abuser? White beater? White abuser?
How do the world see you when they see you?
Because if they see you that way, that's what they call you. Because you're in darkness. But people are the light. That's what God called us to be, what? Light.
That when we walk out of this church, because we're inside now, we're going to act like we're light, whether we is or not. Yeah. But in the minute we get out the door, we click the light on. Don't take but a second to click it off. See, you can act all sanctimony in here. But the minute when we leave out that door, them lights go off. Woo.
Am I right?
Don't take long to turn the light on. But when we get, as soon as we come through that door, they come on. Blessed and highly favored, girl. How you doing? Blessed and highly favored. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hey, yeah, Bible so big you can't hardly carry it. Hallelujah. So it's easy to pretend to be a light. whether to walk in the light. Because when you get around people that you don't, that ain't saints. Yeah. So don't turn it on for one day until I see you again. And you turn it back on. Amen. I'm telling you, let's think about this. Oh God, it's gonna help somebody. Praise God. Now if God was charging you by with a light bill, how much would your bill be? That's a good one. If God charged you by your light bill, what would your bill be? Yeah. Some of your light bill be so low, I can't believe my light bill this low. I'd be one time you'd be glad to get a high light bill. Yeah, I didn't know mine that low. Amen. But that's what he's trying to tell you. We're children of the day and not of the night. Because I'm light. And I want to see light. Because if you're not walking in light, you're not walking in me. Because I'm the light of the world. But not only that, I'm a city that sits on a hill. You can't hide me. Matter of fact, I don't want to be here. He said, do a man light a candle and he hide it under a bushel? Why would I hide today? I don't want the world to know who I belong to. Other than that reason, we got a thing. We try to hide our light under a bushel when we get around certain people. That's the time to shine. Because now you become a witness to God. You're becoming a witness for God. You feel more pretty God's plan and purpose he had for you in your life. When people can see you and see God in you. So let my light shine. Hallelujah. Shining in heaven when I got out there, I did what the world did. Oh God. Water and oil don't mix. Did y'all hear that? One is heavier than the other. They always gonna separate themselves. Try and mix oil and water and see which one goes to the bottom. The oil going down to the bottom. Because they don't mix. The Bible said light and darkness don't mix.
How can I have light in me and darkness as well? Hallelujah.
Praise God. So he said, I am the light of the world. We still talk about God. Because it's all about who? It's all God. Hallelujah. What time is it? Hey, I got one. I got seven, but I ain't gonna finish. Oh God, John 10 and 7, right quick. Yeah, I'm about to close on y'all right now. It's just number 3, so next week I got 4 more. All right, but we still talking about God. I tell you, 7 points in John, he just talking about, he used the statement, I am. It's I am that I am. That's the part I like to shout on. Because when I'm down, he's the only person I can go to. When all hell breaking loose. Amen. You can't solve my problem. But he can. Hallelujah. He takes my greatest problems Hallelujah. He takes them all. But there's something greater. Oh, man, I thank God for who he is. Amen? Yeah. Praise God. Give us some soft music, y'all. Don't quit on me now. Yeah. We finna close, all right? Yeah. Then said Jesus unto them again, verily, verily I say unto you, I am the door of the sheep. Hallelujah. We got the sheep in the house. Where my sheep at? I'm the door of the sheep. Hallelujah. Boy, this is powerful. The whole message is powerful. Oh God. This is going to represent Christ. And he's the door. And that's the door to the sheepfold. Hallelujah. Because he's the shepherd. He's a good shepherd too now. That's even in John too. But I'm the door. And because I'm the door, the reason I lay across the door, can't let my sheep get out unless I let them out. It's for their own protection too now. But I had to lay across there because the wolves was going to try to get in. And because I laid across there, can't nothing get by me except I know it. That I'm so wide, I can't go around. Because I'm the door. If they even try to cross over, I'm over there by the leg. He can't go over me. Hallelujah. In other words, I'm there for your protection. And look, you can go in and out. Have access to the pasture, the green patch for the pool. And you can come back in. But I am that door to the Father. You can't get to him except you come by me. Food, I'll go look for them. And find them that they eat. So I have to go and make sure they get greener pastures. They don't even worry about eating. Oh boy, look at God here. They don't worry about the next meal they're going to get because when that time comes, I leave, I go and start looking. Get on the hill and I look over here and I said, boy, the pastures are green over there. Yeah, I got to let them out. Because now I found what they need. Can y'all see God answering your every need? Because he's a good shepherd. He's a shepherd.